Congressman Bill Johnson of Ohio. Congressman, state your case.
Hi, David. I tell you what, you know, what is concerning to me is that the President of the United States has gone on vacation. Harry Reid and the Senate have gone on vacation, and they've introduced this tremendous uncertainty for America's job creators. I travel all up and down the Ohio River, and the one thing that employers tell me they need most is certainty. And kicking the can down the road is just another Washington gimmick that the American people are dead set against.
Right.
We can't keep doing business this way.
Well, I agree. It is a gimmick, and we've seen a lot of it over the past several years. But will our taxes, is there a chance that by not doing this measure, that I agree, we'll kick it down the road a little bit more, will our taxes be going up on January 1st?
Well, I can certainly tell you that I will not stand for that. And I believe that most of the colleagues that I serve with here in the Republican-led House will not stand for that either. 169 Americans taking home less in their paychecks when they are struggling under these failed economic policies by this administration, we just can't stand that. And you know something else, David, a two-month tax policy, that's almost as bad as a three-plus year budget cycle. Remember, this is the same Senate that kicked this bill back, stripping out everything in it that was good for America. That's the same Senate that has not passed a budget in nearly 3 years.
It did seem like John Boehner was going to go ahead with that two-month deal until there was this conference call that he got on Saturday. Is that your understanding?
Well, I can't speak for the speaker. I think the interview that he gave earlier today, the statement that he gave earlier today, made it very, very clear where he stood. No more Washington gimmicks. Draw a line in the sand. Normal order. Let the process work like it's supposed to. The House agreed on a bill that we think is in the best interest of America. It keeps America's taxes from going up. It created certainty for job creators, especially physicians that are worried about their Medicare reimbursements being cut. It helped seniors who want to make sure that they're going to have access to their health care. And it did unemployment insurance reform in a way that's going to focus on reemployment and giving the states flexibility to get unemployment under control. So there's a lot of good about what we sent over. And this gimmick that the Senate has put on us to try and kick this can down the road, just very, very irresponsible. You mentioned in the intro, furious. We're furious about what we've seen the Senate do here.
Well, Congressman, I love backbone. I love people that stick to their guns and don't move. But I'm just wondering if, in fact, Congress votes this down and if, in fact, the Senate says, okay, we're just going to let this thing sit, then don't taxes go up automatically on January 1st?
Well, we're going to see what happens. I'm not going to support taxes going up on January 1st on 169 million Americans. We can't have that happen. And I want you to remember something. A lot of Americans are concerned about where this money is coming from. Remember, the payroll tax credit comes out of Social Security. This is the first time in American history where we actually paid for a tax cut. Instead of taking that money out of the Social Security Trust Fund, about $183 billion in federal programs that were cut as a means of paying for this payroll tax credit extension. Things like freezing federal employment or federal employees' pay for members of Congress even, and making sure that millionaires don't get to draw unemployment and take advantage of food stamp programs.
You know, I just talked to Gene Sperling. He represents the Obama White House, and he couldn't figure out what was happening with Republicans. I explained to him, you know, a lot of these Republicans were hired by people that want them to do what they have been doing over the past couple of days. It didn't seem to get into his head. But if, in fact, taxes do go up as a result of the Senate doing nothing, the American people are going to blame.
Well, I think the American people are going to blame Washington. You know, they're sick and tired of the gimmicks. They're sick and tired of the trickery. And that's what this is. They see Washington playing politics instead of doing what's right by the American people. Let me ask you to focus
a little bit, because Washington is a big swath. I mean, which part of Washington are they going to blame? Are they going to blame the Republicans in Congress for not making a deal, even though it's only 2 months? Or are they going to blame the Senate for just sitting on this vote by the House?
Well, I'm going to hope that the American people see through the ruse and understand that it's the Senate that's refusing to act. We have sent them 28-plus jobs bills. We sent them a budget that could have avoided all of this. If the Senate would have come to the table in good faith from the beginning and put their plan on the table, then we could have avoided all of this. So I'm hopeful that the American people, and I know they are, the American people are smart enough to figure out we've done our job in the Republican-led House. We've taken care of the American people. We put a bill forward that would protect their taxes from going up and that would ensure that doctors get certainty, job creators get certainty. I think they'll figure it out.
Congressman Bill Johnson, Congressman, thank you very much for joining us. Appreciate it.
Thank you, David. Thank you for having me.
Well, this latest battle.